Welcome everyone. It's P3 time, what everyone loves and is waiting for, usually at least. And next, now that we have this basic system here running and this T2 system ISO for people to get and follow at home, it is time to do graphic stuff. As all of this is quite a lot of work, and this is also why we do these YouTube videos, that people see how much work this actually is. Where is our dongle? Today we start archiving and publishing this old code. Maybe I'm the nearly only one who has it, unless the original developer still has it somewhere. As I said in this other video, I was actually not the original developer of this. I just wanted to take a look after a decade ago and was surprised nobody maintains this in the meantime. What did we have, 19.3 or something like this? I should also really update this. Now that we have this working, failed, probably doesn't exist, so what was it then? It was so close, 19.2 or so. Let's see, does the graphic come up or? Interesting, we have this sometimes. Completely no idea why this happens sometimes. Boot other OS. Maybe something with a display resolution, something, because we powered it on without display attached, and you need to use this reboot because this is doing some special reboot reset thing for the Linux scheme OS. Maybe it happened because we didn't have the display, and maybe this sometimes happens when there is some thing with the display output. So once more, just the same, 19.2 without trying non-existing ones this time. And then we start. We also have two tasks here. First of all, this graphic acceleration. Why did this happen again? This is not fun. So we have two major work items, or after this, a third one being hardware 3D, because initially we are talking 2D and video acceleration. That people are asking for 3D acceleration is a new thing. It was actually not what I planned initially. So boot other OS. So the tasks are first getting this old revamped code to work at all, because I got it working but it's not stable. Not really sure why it doesn't work what did work a decade ago, but we need to figure that out. And then also we are running so far the X server from a decade ago. Obviously there were API and ABI changes. I think now the reboot worked without switching it off, right? So whatever is up with it. Maybe someone of you guys knows it. Maybe I'm running this very old other OS plus. Maybe something was also fixed in the meantime in reboot or rebug or whatever. So 19.2. And so the next step is also to change the code so that it works with the new APIs of Xorg. They usually add functions or remove parameters or add arguments and such and things like this, clean up stuff, throw old, not much used old code. And now we're booting. So I always boot exactly the same. I have no idea why sometimes it doesn't boot and resets, but maybe one of you knows. The reason I do multiple small videos is actually not for clickbait or something. It is simply I have only so much free time in my spare time that I actually do not really have so much, because I also run a company. So this lunch break and night video filming or Christmas days is actually an additional thing for me that I do on top of all my other open source stuff like T2 and ExactImage and other things. I only have so much time at night for this, and also the longer the videos are, the less people watch it. So keeping this brief and shorter videos looks to me not only what I can do on a daily basis, but also what people want to follow up at home. Also, as you hopefully notice, this is an educational channel, so I also want that people learn something, working with open source, working with Linux kernel, working with Git, how stuff work, how you do stuff yourself, because it would be awesome if we have more people doing stuff, contributing stuff, fixing stuff, testing stuff, and this is why we are also doing this here. So let me take a look, what are we actually booting here? This might be the old system, I guess. I have not moved this over yet. We can in T2 installation see this here in in here. So yes, this is a decade old system. This is not what you all run at home, but this doesn't matter so much. Today I mostly wanted to publish the sources here. I moved them over already here to the new system, I guess. We have multiple. This was another build. You see, the last month we also spent doing multiple different builds, 64-bit, 32-bit, in the hopes that it's slightly higher performance. So use the source. What do we have here? Yeah, this is the stuff I was looking for. We probably can move all of this back to this vintage system root, because this is probably what I will keep working with today or the next days, because as I've shown you last time, we had graphic corruption in February, or when this was, in the beginning of the year, so we first need to get this working, and maybe I continue first debugging and fiddling with this in this decade-old system, because with this it was working, 2009 or when that was, with this accelerated X that other people already had working, and then only when it works, because when I now switch over, I have to work against this more modern X server where they have API and ABI changes, and then I have two different things that do not work. So I will probably first try to figure out to get this graphic artifacts and corruption working, and then after some nights or so, move this over to the new X server for you to share. But what I want to do already now is, you see we have here XF86 video PS3 and old, and these are the historic sources that I was actually doing an internet search if someone was working on this, and I could not find this at all anymore. So as I said, unless some original developer kept some of those, but they somehow all disappeared, I might be the nearly only one. So let's publish them finally here, and for now I will upload this to GitHub, so you will also see how to push something to GitHub. And these source trees here are already modified, so let's check. I hope I have them also here in T2, in download, Miro X. So here I hope I have this. If not, yeah, I have here, I see already there are some, actually quite some. PS3 would also help. So here you see, okay, there we have here three apparently snapshots. And I hope these are exactly, actually they're not so many days apart. What is, by the way, the last we have in T2? The pity is that somehow they never made it on the T2 mirrors. Normally we should have this also, because I made the package for this, but due to whatever download failure reason, we don't have this on the mirrors. So the last one we ever had in T2 was 1116. That matches what we have here, 1116. And yeah, it is a bit larger. So what I want to do next, because the local ones I already modified here and they are not in Git or something, so I do not have something where I can directly do, and actually this says Git. Let's see, Git diff. Oh, cool. We are lucky that this is some Git snapshot. So you see, I have here some error messages. I clear VRAM, what? Okay. Maybe I removed this because I want to see debug stuff. You see, I was editing around here, just random stuff that I needed for debugging. And this is actually quite nice. Here you see I have here some RSX base, just some debug prints. And in the one that I got working a little bit, because I had to go here through step by step. Here was, by the way, they skipped here some FIFOs. The reason why I do the S3 Verge videos is also that you have some simple stuff to follow, where there is a specification, where there are already some terms explained, like FIFO, first in, first out, command buffer, ring buffer, and vertexes, textiles, triangles, and rasterization, and so on, and transforms and stuff, because obviously in this S3 Verge everything is way simpler. And card, this didn't work for, this was actually really stupid thing, that this were 32-bit values, and while I was running this as 64-bit programs, user space applications, of course this card 32 could not hold the 64-bit pointers. And in this I really modified around for a week or two nights and such in February or when it was. And here I really fiddled around enormously with this command submission here in this DMA area, and because this didn't really work much until I got this working to some degree. And of course, you see this is the old one. Here are some casts here that didn't work. You see the same card 32, some 32-bit value too, just long. And also simple printf, because obviously there's so much stuff going on that it's often easier to have some printouts in a log to understand what's going on, because obviously I've not written this. And additionally, I was neither an NP3 nor an NVIDIA expert, but we're getting there. And the biggest fiddling around here was in this ring buffer stuff. And here this, you see DMA kickoff. I changed here stuff around until things got working and so on. And yeah, actually not so much, mostly just fiddling around that it works a little bit. And to start this winter season of P3 RSX programming, we will now publish the sources to GitHub. And later this winter, I probably will also do more live streaming. We have done one test to see how this is going. And we will also, not the next days or weeks, but maybe in 2 weeks' time or so, do a live stream or two of some hours of testing here. So best share, like, and subscribe to join this later on. And so now let's get to GitHub and publish the sources that all of you have them archived and can start tinkering and send me patches and such. And let me get maybe a second keyboard. Wait a second, I just realized I was mentally prepared to commit here this Git snapshots to GitHub, but as we have this here with full history, yeah, that is cool. Then we can initial import of PS3 exoctriver derived from fbdiff. So this is the original author, this is Glau Rung. This is of course super cool that due to this, look here, this is even upstream, even back in this day. I'm not making this shit up. 2007, you see, even there I sent him already the super travel fix for running in 64-bit. So I'm not making up that I'm contributing left and right, even if it's sometimes only small bits and pieces to all these various projects. What is cool on this history that we can... The only thing is I do not use Git every day. This was probably not the right syntax, or... I know this is probably diffing from this to that revision here. Need to memorize more Git command syntax. But anyway, with all this history, I should be able to push this directly to GitHub to preserve all the history. That is way more amazing than I was hoping for. So download here, mirror, so set standard, decompress, XF86 video PS3, and then the last version we have archived from a decade ago. Unicode, is it? No, this is not. Waiting for the day that targets direct support for set standard. XF86, so now we only need to figure out the syntax to push this to my GitHub account. That is a funny message. I created this here already, this empty repository at my GitHub. And they have here, this repository is empty. Care to check out the GitHub channel on YouTube? No, of course not. Check out my channel on YouTube. They have here some quick setup tips. And I usually do not have to do this to import a whole other repository. So let's try if this works. No idea if it will work. We can probably revert this later also, but not sure if it commits this, probably doesn't commit this. The original origin here of this was Mendos, Home Linux, Org, Glau, Rung, Git, XF86, Video, PS3, Git. Of course that doesn't exist anymore, maybe some private home DSL server or something. So let's see, push an existing repository from the command line, so Git remote at origin https github com rxr bln xf86 video ps3.git. Let's see if we typed this in correctly here. Remote origin already exists. Maybe this Git is also a little bit old and we maybe want to update this here. Let's see how this is going. do we have here? I usually check the T2 config just quickly with VI. On this slower machine, size optimized, no debug. And this will obviously rebuild everything here on this decade old system, as you can see. So missing only. Let's see what this will still build. A whole lot of doc stuff. TCLTK, I hope it doesn't need everything of this. Let's try with depth none and hope we get an upgraded git. Okay, well, I'm not really in the mood to wait here forever. We could also see, do I have a new git here? Okay, not in the crossbow, so then we have to wait. So while we wait, we can already see if rm origin works. Did not match any file. What was exactly what we typed in here? And this is, by the way, my biggest problem with Git, that this syntax stuff is so complicated that unless you work the whole day on the Linux kernel, you barely knew all this esoteric command stuff here. Does not have rm. Okay, but this is still the old version, so then let's wait for the newly compiled one. So let's see how this new git is doing. Does it do, yeah, syntax changed in a decade. So then back here, xf and origin again. Oh, that worked. So now, because a decade ago this most likely was just a regular git clone, it probably misses the tags and branches and whatnot, but any history is better than nothing. So git push, the current branch master has no upstream branch. What? The current branch master has no upstream branch. I don't know what that means. Just some website here that an internet search spits out. So maybe to copy with all the tags and branches, which we cannot do anymore because that is offline for a decade or so, that would be git fetch tags. Also, which we can't do anymore. So remote rm origin we have done, and git remote add origin we also have done. So push origin all. Let's see what that is doing. Push origin, was it this? B origin. Wonderful protocol restriction not applied to curl redirect because your curl version is too old. Yeah, decade old. Then let's see if we can also emerge curl. I have the feeling this will be quite long endeavor of re-merging here quite some stuff. I hope the OpenSSL from a decade ago will be sufficient. Somehow I have the feeling not. We could cheat though and just log into another server and try from there, which maybe we do while we try this. Speed things up, copy to a server. So let's see what was our password there. It's doing something. So let's see if that is online. So P3 is obviously still building curl. Probably also want to disable Xtrace here. Keeps logs a little bit smaller. So let's see what we got here. This is on GitHub, RxR Berlin, XF86 video P3. And yes, GitHub might not be the most popular anymore after Microsoft purchased it, but that is where we can temporarily store things. We can still move it anywhere else later to GitLab or Xorg or Xercode or wherever. And ironically, the last commit here right now is from me. I wonder slightly fixes rendering. So you can browse the history here and read the source and tinker on this. The only thing you're missing are these local changes here, and I used this old version here from October because it was smaller. Again, you're not missing much, only some debug logging and getting stuff to work. Here some FIFO fiddling until things started to move again. And this is not fully debugged, so it will crash rather quickly and have graphic corruptions anyway. So unless you are a developer, most users would just waste their time because it simply doesn't work stable. So most users are better off to wait until someone takes a look, like me or someone else. Again, this is after a decade and a YouTube summer here. This is not so much more time until things should be hopefully more working. And after this next year, we can also take a look on 3D stuff. Although I definitely need many more subscribers and views and such to work on this, because we also have plenty of other things to do. Working exa, wonder what exactly this commit looks like. As you can see, DMA stuff here filling into the ring buffer, similar to the verge, coordinates shifted here to the right format and location. And this is again why we have done this S3 verge, to get people a little bit basic understanding of the things, because obviously for this NVIDIA stuff, things look way more advanced and complicated, with many more options, features and everything. There we have the stuff online. Finally, also another hour well spent, and curl broke anyway. Thanks God we committed this on the server. And so that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. I wish you Merry Christmas or otherwise nice seasonal time. If you do not tune back in the next days, I wish you a happy new year already. Again, don't forget to share, like, and subscribe for all the other tinkering and hardware, driver, operating system awesomeness to come. And while we are at it, I think two people asked for the kernel sources, and I mentioned this already. The kernel sources are in the ISO image, and I have not yet committed them to T2 because the problem is these are this many. The problem is I want to keep the T2 sources mean and clean, and it's mostly vanilla and not so much patched. And if I have here 15 or whatnot P3 patches, this already does not look so vanilla anymore. And we could move it here to Arch PowerPC, actually PowerPC 64. The problem is, I think we have here some inheritance of packages and patches, but I think it would not work. I need to read the source actually for this, because I think I cannot simply move them to the PowerPC directory. I think they do not apply. We have here detect patch files, so confdir, confdir cross zero, cross, and then inherited target chain package patch. And actually we do get them from, get additional patches from, no, this could actually work. If it's not the confdir, contains the desk file which overrides the default if confdir, so I guess that could work then, because then I would hesitate less if we have this only in PowerPC 64 here, in package svn mkdir linux. And then I can probably move package base linux and then all this zero something is PS3. Look how many these are. Move all of this to here, and this way they only affect the PowerPC 64 build. Okay, before I SVN add them, let's see if this actually builds. So let's see. Yeah, only very little left. Okay, this red pooling. This was a hot fix for some. Let's delete this. You see how much stuff, by the way, I have so much stuff laying around here. This is all my uncommitted work, all work in progress, half working, a little working, some unfinished business, new package and stuff that does not yet build or not yet cross-compile. So yeah, this is why we do YouTube videos now. So back to base Linux. We have what left? We have an update. Oh, we have an update pending here. Let's see. Why did I not yet commit this? You see how much stuff we have to do. And in between we want to do YouTube videos. So this probably builds, and let's commit this. And update to this again. And commit this. And then let's do a test build of PowerPC 6432 job 1 Linux and see if we get this patches applied. We can put this in the background and then let's build PowerPC 6432 var ADM log 1 Linux out. This is a nearly epic data center server, so it's not too slow, except when you're waiting for something. Actually, maybe we are not building in TempFS, then IO performance is not super amazing there. Actually, I could use a local Ryzen though. So let's see, here's something applying. And yeah, this is applying, so awesome. This indeed does work as intended. This kind of more esoteric configuration features even I'm not using every day. And then even me as principal author and project coordinator need to read here the source for checking out if that works. But then we can have them here in subversion for everyone to just check out. But again, I was not hiding this. You have seen this on YouTube. These are mostly unmodified patches that you would otherwise find already from a decade ago. Of course, you would have slightly rediffed them, which I've done, except the few that are disabled because I didn't need them. And now let's commit this here. Imported ps3 Linux PowerPC64 patches. And again, the ISO already contains them, completely GPL compliant. So if you install the ISO, you would have had a user source Linux patches directory with this patches hopefully in there. And you did not even have to install it. You could have just extracted the tarball, but now they are in our subversion repository for everyone to enjoy. And with this, we finally conclude this video. And again, give it a thumbs up to support my work here, and I hope to see you soon.